Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Stealwing 3 Plays, the Darkest Dungeon. My name is Stealwing 3, and I'm just taking a look-see here at the stagecoach to see if there's anybody we really want. And, you know, let's sort by level real quick here. Take a look-see. I mean, I wouldn't mind. We need, like, a second rower. I'll take the Houndmaster. Fuck it. Why not? Take that guy.
Warman and his faithful beast. A bond forged by battle and bloodshed.
Alright, cool. So what are we doing today? Today, we've gotten all of our level 3 bosses out of the way, so we can actually do level 3 dungeons with people if we want to. So let's just, we'll go back to the Unholy Slayer's Ring is pretty good. The Blasphemous Vial from this long veteran dungeon is actually a very tempting offer. Book of Holiness, not bad. The Sacred Scroll from this long veteran dungeon as well. So it seems like we might want to... We already have a Blasphemous Vial, but I would love to get a Sacred Scroll back. The idea of a long dungeon terrifies the hell out of me, though. But I'm not sure. Book of Holiness might not be bad. Unholy Slayer's Ring. Please stop with the thing. Get out of here. Soothing Mask. No, that seems stupid. Eldritch Slaying Ring seems stupid. Yeah, I know what's beneath you. Just get the fuck out. Just get out of here. I'm trying to think, goddammit. Supply run might not be bad. It might be good to do that. Let's do this. And we will send in the bottom of the barrel boys here. Right, what do you got? You got Abyssal Artillery. Okay, good. Yeah, that's where you want to be. You can live there. It's fine. It's actually pretty ideal. And you're good in the front. All right, cool. Let's drink it up and let's get this show on the road, shall we? Soldiers old as time. What are your abilities again? Do you have Defender? You do not have Defender. You've got Bellow, which I think it might be hot trash, actually. So let's go to the guild. Take a look here. I think Bellow might be hot trash. Marks themselves, then debuffs a bunch of other targets. Let's do this. Get him leveled up here. And then Percy, do you have your shit all leveled up? Yeah, as high as it'll go, at least. Nothing to it but to do it. All right, cool. And then everyone's got gear and stuff. You do not. Let's get you geared up. We're not going to give him a second tier of gear, though, because I feel like that might not be a great idea. All right. Yeah, I don't care about the stun amulet. The supply run one, though, I think might be good, because I think that lets us take extra supplies when we do the next dungeon that we do. And I think if that's actually the case, that would be actually be super ideal, because then we could do one of those long dungeons and potentially potentially lead to maybe some good things. Let's do this. You don't need a crit. Yeah, it's fine. Plus 4 bleed, plus 1 dodge. Yeah, let's do this, and let's send you in with the doll. Let's send him in with the speed cloak, I think is better. That's good. And then you can take the lucky dice because they're like actually just super good. I mean, 4 accuracy is garbage, but you know, 4 dodge is super good. And we'll send him in with, let's do like damage stone. No, that's stupid. Dodge stone, stupid. Stupid, stupid, stupid. That's actually not bad. Let's send him in with that. And then you can get sent in with this thingy. And I, like, really hate all of our trinkets, by the way. Like, we have, like, a set of trinkets that are good for, like, one particular group of characters. I just want to, like, try to organize us in such a way. I guess that'll be fine. All right. Let's go ahead and provision. Let's do this. And we'll, or medium mission, so let's bring 26, 3, 3, 15 should be good, and then two of these and two of these. Good! Alright, let's do it. Hopefully this works out fine. We're going to the Warrens, actually, so let's bring Med Herb with us. That'll be good. Let's do that. Good. Oh, it loaded quickly. All right.
Even the fiercest beast will lay down when it is not eaten. Steal their food.
Steal their food. All right, let's pop this thing. I'm going to pop some tags. This team's a little weird, and having just an occultist as our healer makes me a little nervous. It's not that bad, all things considered, but there's a chance it's gonna be bad, if that makes sense. Like, as it stands, it's not that bad. But as we go forward, having only a single target healer might not be the greatest thing in the universe. Because today is the greatest. Portraits are great. Happy to see those. We gotta start thinking about, like, our trinket game and going and doing targeting dungeons down that, like, in particular give us, like, particular trinkets. We don't know if there's any combat ahead, but I will be safe and pop a couple torches since we're going down this hallway semi into the unknown here. Such blockage. I just don't want to bump into somebody and have that fight get replaced with, like, a ghoul encounter, because that doesn't sound very fun, and frankly, I don't really like the ghouls or anything like that. It's pretty bad. No scouts, huh? Fucking real talk here. Game's really not being nice to me today.
Ancient.
That's gonna suck in a little while here. We might actually have to camp to deal with our wounds at this rate. Nothing really? Okay, well, I don't want to camp. Mistakes were very clearly made here. Good. Does any of these guys have, like, a terrible quirk? I mean, weak grip on life should go. Weak grip is annoying, but not that big of a deal. Known treat and dysmania is fine. Ignore those. Torn rotators, fine. Ignorable. Virtue chance down is annoying. Let the man-at-arms do it. All right, so I'm pretty sure that if we do this and then put a torch to it, it should, like... Yes, weak grip on life has been removed. Actually super good. There we go, fucking finally. Jesus Christ. This took a fucking 1,000 years. Alright, that's not a charming one, which is good. Which is very good. We'll do Houndsherry, because I feel like it's actually, like, super strong in here. We will do Harvest, because Harvest is also very strong in here. Bleeds are real good in the Warrens, if I'm not mistaken. Really need to heal him. On Death's Door is not great. Do that. Good for heal. Get him off Death's Door. Book of Sanity. The Dodge Stone. Fine. Your inability to dodge shit is horrifying, to say the least. I forgot to put on Defender for you, so we will go ahead and do... let's bolster everybody. Hopefully give us the ability to get ahead of them on the next round with their healer. That should be good. Hopefully? Question mark? I don't know. Maybe.
Teetering on the brink, facing the abyss.
Facing the abyss.
Do this. Hopefully make these guys bleed out. It's looking pretty good so far. Ow. Well, please don't get stunned. Oh, no. That means that our jester has to now survive a round of being bled. Which is not ideal, to say the least. Or we kill all of them. Is option B. But I don't think option B is going to happen. Like, at all. But we'll see. Resisted the bleed. Oh, thank God. Big heal. Thank you, Lord. That was lucky. Like, I commented on the fact that the game was not being nice to me, that it immediately was super nice to me. Why are you going last? Aren't you, like, the fastest one on the team? He's got 8 speed. Your speed's 9. How did you go last? I don't understand. We'll do this. Here we go. What do we want to do? Hounds rush. There we go. Perfect. Easy. Give them no quarter. Easy peasy. We will definitely camp in the next room to hopefully deal with a little bit of this stress and some of this damage, because it's not great. Not great at all. I really don't like camping for heals. It like feels bad to do, but do this. Does anybody have wound care? No, nobody has wound care is what you're telling me. That's fine. That's fine. Let's take a second. Think about what we want to do here. The therapy dog, I guess. It's not going to help with the damage at all, but it's something. It certainly is something. Do this. This is also good. All right. There we go. Not so bad.
The match is struck. A blazing star is born.
Alright, cool. Let's back out. Go this way. Gotta search all the rooms, because we're looking for these grain sacks. If we don't find a single one of them over here, I am gonna be a little bit upset. But, the lack of wound care sucked. And then that comboed with the fact that, you know, both of our squishy characters are getting their asses beat, which reminds me. There we go. That's helpful. Because then I can use Defender on, like, him to make sure that we're not getting our shit kicked in that badly. I mean, he's got, what, 8 HP? Yeah, that's he's got to get healed. Like, it would have been less scary if I had him defendered, because then, like, we know the Man-at-Arms is going to be taking the damage. Guard Dog would also be great, but we don't have Guard Dog. Guard Dog would have been pretty good, though. Probably would have replaced the Whistle with Guard Dog, to be honest, because the Whistle's not very useful with the setup. And it's better to have another character that just marks the targets. In particular, with, like, a move that actually just marks targets. Like, Deceitful Shot, I believe, marks targets. We gotta get rid of you. So let's do that. Harvest. Not so great. Met Miss is pretty nasty. Heals good. And then we will do Bolster. Bolster's just really strong. It's, like, kind of hard to... Kind of hard not to do it. Good dodge. Just because it like generally is beneficial. The damage up is really good. It's for 4 battles, that damage up? Oh, that's from weapon practice. Oh, okay. I was having a minute there. I was like, Jesus Christ. I did not think it was that strong, but... There you go, I guess. Ball and chain. Sucks. No stun? Fuck. That's okay. That bleed's minor. Annoying, but not bad. Which is fine. Good bleeds. How are we so slow? Like, I get it. Like, we haven't been doing that great, but fuck me, game. We are not that slow. Crush you. Oh! Big damage from that crush. Crush does a serious chunk of damage. It's also got a huge chance to debuff their protection now, which is good. I'm happy about that. We'll go ahead and protect him, I think. Assuming he does not go immediately. Which he did, but, you know, he's bleeding a little bit. But we gotta heal him, so... Let's get that taken care of. Is broken. Maintain the offensive. 14! Good heal. Nice! Nice! Alright, I think he's not quite dead, but... It's close. Butcher Cut fucking sucks. Should have bought fucking bandages, apparently. I did not realize that this was gonna be this big of a deal, to be honest. Corpse that. We need to get another heal off. 6. It's going to counteract the bleed damage he's going to take, inevitably. There you go. Alright, cool. Battle Ballad. Go ahead and speed him up to hopefully kill this guy before he goes. Confidence. Perfect. Alright. I guess that's fine. Not super happy about it, but I guess it's fine. Got a couple curios up this way. 3 curios, in fact. I'm really hoping... My hope... is that we go up there and it's literally all of the grain sacks.
And now the the true test. Hold fast or expire.
Pull him off death's door. Goes back on death's door. We'll go camp again and deal with our wounds. We'll try to, at least. I know we don't have any means of doing it, but just even the food from the campfire is normally enough. That's like better than not doing anything, I guess. I guess. I don't know, man.
In a maze.
Really not great. We need to do this. Then this, I guess. The stress reduction is good, and really not happy about this. It's a lot of bad luck, to be honest. They're targeting our back line, like, a lot, which I appreciate. I could probably mitigate by, you know, murdering the ones that are killing our back line a whole bunch, but, you know. It was indeed one of the sacks, though, which is great. Happy about that.
Waiting to be spent.
Pop that in there. Get one of these babies. Coming into a fight. It's just a bunch of the collected. The collected are actually the easiest thing we could be fighting right now, which is horrifying, to say the least. Go ahead and heal him, because he's going to die if you don't. Good, no bleed as well. Fan-fucking-tastic. Everything's coming up, Millhouse. Let's go ahead and bolster. We should really probably be opening with Defender on, like, our Jester or on the Occultist, but, you know, that would be the smart thing to do, and God knows that I'm not the smart man, right? You guys have been watching the series. I'm just lucky. That's all I am. Smart man would have come in here with a Vestal. Smart man would have done literally anything but this team, probably. I'm not having good luck with Jesters, though, to be honest. They're not long for this world, generally speaking. But cut you guys. My hope is that if we can just stack enough bleeds, we'll mitigate a lot of the healing and the protection buffs and just, like, cut through these guys really easily. That's the hope, at any rate. Son of a bitch. Are you fucking kidding me? Gonna definitely do Defender on him, because so low. Heal on yourself. That's fine. You're not the target I want to kill anyway. Do this. Perfect. Hound's Harry again. Get more bleeds stacked, hopefully. Nope. Looks like they're not having it. God, that fucking protection buff is absurd. We're, like, barely doing any damage now. We're, like, relying almost entirely on this bleed to make this happen. These heals are good, and they're landing well, but not happy about it. Headstrong. We'll crit 9 healing. That sucks. So bad. Literally the worst. Go and do that. Marked him. Get his repost damage come back up a little bit. Perfect. Good. Yes. Perfect. Big damage. Exactly what we needed. Alright, dead, and gonna be dead soon, though. So that's great. That's super good. Let's go and battle Ballad. Try to speed everyone else up so we can maybe get some heals off before they all drop dead.
Unforeseen.
It's like, this guy's dead, so we don't have to worry about him at all. This guy's gonna be dead next round, so we don't have to worry about him either. Heal yourself. 14! Hell yeah. Big heal. Big heals all around. Bolster again. That guy's dead. I'm hoping we can get a second heal off. That's why we're sort of, like, baiting it out a little bit. Just a little bit. Just a little bit. Just a little bit. Alright, cool. Let's do this. Cool. Good heal. And then we'll just kill this guy.
Continue the onslaught. Destroy them all.
Alright. In we go. Not another grain sack, unfortunately. Would have been really nice if it was another grain sack, to be honest. Let's start off with Battle Ballad. Get everybody sped up. Then we'll do Hound's Harry. Oh, with a big crit on the a Swine Wretch back there. Dealing some serious damage. Ooh, big damage. Big fucking damage. Doesn't even matter. Let's do a Crush Chino. Oh, get out of here. Get out of here. stun sucks. Not happy about the stun. But our luck has fucking flipped around a little bit here, which is nice. Stun his ass. There's no reason to do either, though, so we'll do this. He's dead, so that's why I'm not nervous about it. I would like to get some heals off, if at all possible, as well. Let's do a bolster.
Slowly. Gently. This is how a life is taken.
Alright, let's mash him again, because it's a good chance to stun still, if I'm not mistaken. Nope, that's right. Battle Ballad. Get everyone sped up more. More speed. Speed is key. Minor bleed. Crush. Good. 7 damage. That crush is doing some serious fucking work right now. Ow. Stop it. Get some help. Really annoying. Like, it's not even like, he's not even hurting him. He's just like, just stun the healer. Why not? Fuck these guys, right? Asshole. Crit that. Put this here. A little bit of extra food. Just a little bit. There is 2 curios over here, so we have to go investigate them. Which means we have to take this fight, which I'm not looking forward to. Does anybody have a quirk that I want to get rid of? Slow draw blows. Diurnals kind of sucks. So does Mercurial, for that matter. Dysomania and Known Cheat are fine. Sanitophobia sucks, and so does Weak Grip, for that matter. So let's do you. Burn these. Sanitophobia has been removed. Good. It's a knife rack. Probably actually didn't need to take this fight, because I kind of spied the knife rack a little bit right before we, like, got into the fight. And I probably, a smarter player probably would have just backed up off of this immediately, but, you know, I'm not a smarter player. I'm me, Stealwing. Can only be as smart as I am, right? Right? That's the way that works, I believe. Alright, let's do this. Get some big damage down from Percy. His damage and accuracy are down? Or his dodge gets reduced by that? What does that say? He got debuffed for some reason. It must be like one of these guys must be avenging. Yeah, that'll do it. Do this. Defender his ass. I just don't want him to get hit. If we can avoid it. That would be nice. This. Impressive. Get out of here. A lot of bleeds on this guy right now. Really putting the hurt on him. Heal yourself for 6. It's like good-ish. Really want to get our man-at-arms healed up a little bit if we can. Good. 11 crits, also good. The stress damage is negligible. Something we can ignore, I think. I'm going to go with we can ignore it. Because that's just, I'm going to believe that in my mind's eye.
A singular strike.
I am going to be honest, though. We are not doing so hot. We've already used both of our camps, and we've barely done half the dungeon, which is not great. Kill this guy. Thank you.
Size alone does not dissuade the sharpened
blade. All right, well, we might as well finish this direction. Who's got the highest stress? 7, 8, 16. 16 it is. There you go. Minus 10. That's good. Come in here. See if we get a scout, maybe? Nope. No, that's alright. Back it up. Back it up. Back it in. Let me begin. We're gonna not pop any torches till we get all the way back to here, I think. Unless there's a fight coming up, in which case we will pop them then. We did get 1 grain sack, which I guess I can't be mad then. This was the proper direction to come. Hopefully we'll get the other 2 really quickly down here, and then we can just leave, because we're keeping on top of the damage, but we are a little beat up. A little bit. A second healer or a more consistent healer would be nice, or an AoE healer. Basically, I want a Vestal instead of the Occultist. The Occultist is very good for a lot of reasons. He's just not so good for healing. He's not good as a primary healer. He is good as a spot healer for situations where perhaps you need to get 1 really huge heal. Like, somebody's on death's door, right? When someone's on death's door, he has, like, the odds of getting them the highest. No. When somebody isn't on death's door, like, when they're very hurt but they're not on death's door, he's the best kind of healer, because his heal could be massive, like simply massive. But the Vestal's the best all-around healer, in my opinion. Pop this.
The way is lit. The path is
look all this way. Immediately hit a blockage.
The strength to follow it.
Hopefully we don't hit too many more of those because we only have one shovel left. I did pack one less shovel than I normally do. Mostly because we always ended up with one shovel left over at the end of every dungeon. Too many keys as well, I think. There's a second sack of grain.
Wealth cool. Beyond measure. Awarded to the brave and the foolhardy alike.
Immediately less hellish than the areas we were in before. Ugh. The scouts are nice. That's like the main reason the bounty hunter is really good, is because the bounty hunter has like tons of abilities that like increase his scouting chance, which is really good. We will pop a couple torches as we enter this fight, just to make sure that they're not getting the fucking benefit from the darkness. Good hits. No bleeds across the board, which kind of sucks. The bleeds across the board are the reason that Hound's Harry is better than Hound's Rush and against multiple targets. But if you're not getting that, then it's less good. Do this. Really want to get rid of these Carrion Eaters so we don't have to worry about them anymore. This guy's annoying, but we can deal with the stress damage pretty easily. The actual damage is kind of our breaking point a little bit. And the blights would be a little nasty if we're not careful here. Yeah, get rid of that guy. Just get rid of him. Crush is so good. So good. He's dead. Or he's not dead. I thought I saw one, but it's the Carrion Eater's got one left. Comes of Doom. Annoying, but again, ignorable. Totally fine. That guy's dead. He's dead now, too. So, yeah, just cut him down. Just cut him down. Totally fine. Let's dump.
Confidence is a slow and insidious killer.
I don't want to dump the rest of our food in case we bump into a tile. Let's pop this for a small buff, apparently. I was not aware that was a buff. I thought these things made light. I just realized that the citrine, that thing was worth more than the citrine. I'm an idiot. It was a bad decision. Center this on the party here. Stack of books. Stack of books is a stress reliever or it'll be a damage booster. Let's do this for you. Good. Who's got a good disarm? 70, 80, 70. 80 it is. There we go. And get rid of this stress damage thing, but I don't think I need to. Cool. Into this room. I'm really hoping we'll find that second grain sack before, like, too much trouble arises. Because, frankly, we're running low on resources to, like, get through the dungeon with. And, I'd really like to leave I'd like to keep the money that we've accrued. Because, it would be very useful to keep the money we've accrued. Like, tremendously useful. Let's heal you. 14, good, he's back to full. Spend a little bit of time healing here, I think, will be not a bad idea. Go ahead and cut you. I harvested to get rid of the corpse. I meant to do slice off, but... Oh, get out of here. Get the fuck out of my face. He's dead, right? No, he's not dead. He didn't bleed. Alright, so stress heal on you. Stress healing. Stress healing. I'm playing the song called Stress Healing. It's the same song Stealwing sings in his head when he's having a bad run in Darkest Dungeon. Dead. That's the stress healing song. It'll be on my next album.
Pride precipitates a dizzying.
You know, Man Without a Dream. Let's do this. Pop this thing. A blue one this time, huh? A blue one. Cool. Alright, another fight, more food as well, which we have met herb for, so we can make that happen, which is great. Kill the swine wretch, gotta make sure we're not getting diseases. I know we already caught one, by the way, I did see that earlier. My hope is that that will not matter too much. Alright, let's do this. 11 heal, no bleed. Good, no bleed. Then we'll crush you. The swine wretch is dead. We just need to deal with this lady. And then we will stun lock the swine chopper as best we can, I think, is what we're going to do here. Just keep doing ball and chain. I'm actually okay with that. Because ball and chain does, like, no damage. It's way, way, way less punishing than butcher cut. Because butcher cut's, like, actually the worst. Even if it's pushback, we can still do, we can still do bolster from the back. And defender, I believe. Which is good, because that's what we want to do. Yeah, butcher cut's way, way more punishing than all the other things. Good crit for 6. The bleed's not great, though. Super not happy about that. Oh!
Obliterated.
Get out of here. I know we've got like 2% bonus crit, but fuck me, dude. Dude's critting like crazy. Doing crazy damage. He's literally crushing it. Oh my god. It's just so much damage. From our tank, too. Like, it's like... It's like when you play a ret paladin, you know? You do like the... You do like bubble tanking. Or hard healer tanking in WoW. Does not work well, for the record. I'm not advocating for hard healer tanking. But, shit's cray. We are gonna go down and see if it's down there. And then if it's not one of these two... Correction. If it's one of these two, then we're good to go. If it's not one of these two, we're gonna be in a little bit of trouble here, to be honest with you. Because then we're gonna hit a blockage. And have to deal with that, which I don't wanna. Let's cut you down. Probably really need to remember to use my fucking biscuits at some point. Do this. Forgot to swap these two back around. That's my bad.
Exposed to a healing blow.
Oh no. Right, zero damage is good. Oh, please don't. Right, zero damage is good still. Oh no. Definitely gonna need to use Defender on you. Go ahead and just do that. You're gonna need to heal him as well. Alright, it's not a lot of healing, but it's better than nothing, I'm gonna go with. Bleed? Good bleed, he's dead. Okay. Don't have to worry about that guy anymore. Do this. Good. Blanket fire, zero damage again. 2 damage across the board. 13 back though. It's good for us. That guy's dead. Good. Don't do Rain of Whips. Do like punish or like point blank shot or something. Oh no. Fucking one healing. Ah, oh, god damn it. No damage is good though. Stress damage is annoying but fine. He's gotta go. The blanket fire is actually deadly. Right now. We're in kind of a weird spot where an ability that I normally ignore is actually like the worst thing that could happen to us.
Terrible vistas of emptiness.
This. When we're perhaps not in a situation where he's gonna die if I don't keep getting the heal off before this guy goes, then we'll worry about the stress damage. For now, I'm gonna go ahead and crush this guy, I think. Another rain of whips. Zero damage across the board is still good. The bleeds are getting nasty, though. Like, really nasty. He's gotta go.
Perched at the very
gotta go.
Of oblivion.
He's gotta go, and we gotta get a better heal than, like, 2 or 3 here. Like, it needs to happen. Alright, he's not dead, but... Come on, fucking 3? Dude, come on, work with me here, man. You've been doing... Had a couple kick-ass ones for a little bit there. Good dodge. This guy's dead this turn, so we can... I don't want to blackjack him, because I don't want him to die, because I need to heal our jester. He's going to take a million damage here. There we go. Back on death's door. He needs to do a stress heal on himself to stop him from breaking. Needs to go. Good. 10. 10 heals. Good. We're also going to bleed out, but... You are not currently gonna die if I don't heal you, so... Fucking bleeds, man. The bleeds. So bad.
Size has no intrinsic merit, unless inordinate exsanguination be considered a virtue.
The bleeds are so bad. Alright, down we go. There's a scroll.
Darkness holds much worse than mere trickery.
Touch it. Boogeyman. Ah, that's not great. Masochistic. Actually okay, because that'll mark him.
Injury. Find it in no short supply.
He's gonna break too.
Injury and despondence set the stage for heroism.
Okay, back cowardice. It up. This is not the direction we need to go. Okay. He's gonna break. Vigorous, nice. Actually very good.
Adversity can foster hope and resilience.
Good. All right. We know this is not the direction to go. That's a barrel, and it can't be... What we're looking for can't be in the treasure room, so... We know that can't be the direction we have to go, so we go this way. That's the name of the game. Charming guy's gotta go. All hands on deck here. Charming guy's gotta go. In fact, Charming guy's got to go. Damn it, we weren't quite fast enough. Tuna beguiling, not great. Luckily, he's already gone, so we don't have to worry about that, but oh no! Hang in there, dude. Heal him good for 4. This all count as human, right? Yeah. Well, I mean, the pigmen do. Oh no, that's gonna be a bad bleed, isn't it? No, no bleed. Okay, good. Good, good. Good. Hang in there, guys. I'm trying really hard to keep you guys in this. Good. Get rid of that guy. Pull our Houndmaster back. That. It's actually not what I wanted to do, but it worked out. Get rid of him. Protect him. Was it a good move? It was not a good move. Well, you know, it was a good move. Return damage is going to be fine. He need to heal himself. For 1. You know what? It's off death's door. That's all that matters here. We're going to have to do a harvest to get rid of all these corpses. Definitely. He healed himself. Oh my god, that's awesome. I mean, it was for 1.
These nightmarish creatures can be felled.
A questionable health potion. Let's have you drink that. Even if he gets a disease, we have to go through this stupid thing, so like everyone's gonna take some damage and some stress. Flesh
and indefatigable purpose.
Oh no, the secret room. I will get it on the way back. Oh, the grain sack. Thank God. Thank God. How did we do this? Continue adventuring. Let's go to the secret room real quick here. And then we'll leave. Oh my god, we did not deserve to get out of here. This was pretty close here.
And baubles, paid for in blood.
Yeah, paid for in the blood and sweat of my fucking tears here. Jesus Christ.
These foodstuffs yield double benefit. The town may eat, and the swine will not.
Yes. Yes. It's actually very good. We made a lot of money off of that too, which is great. Alright, Meditator is good. Lazy Eye is not. Zoophobia is annoying, but not that big of a deal.
Surplus. A rare and wonderful
thing. Nice. That's going to be really useful, especially if we decide to do a long mission, which we might, depending on what the trinkets look like. Dark Tambourine. Dark Tambourine is awful. Martyr Seal could be good. Book of Sanity is awful. Tough Ring. That's what we want. We want this one. So on the next episode, we're going to be going in for an exterminate mission using the best team we could possibly assemble out of our level 3s. But for now, I'm going to thank you all so much for watching. If you guys like what you saw, let me know. If you guys want to see more, don't forget to subscribe to keep up to date on when I post more videos. If you guys really like what you saw, leave a like. Helps the channel grow. Helps me out a great deal. if you guys have any tips or anything that you guys, you know, think I'm missing or things I should know, tell me in the comments. You know, I do read all the comments, and I think it would be very interesting and very useful to hear from you guys once again. So, yeah, with that, thank you all so much for watching. Catch you guys in the next video. Bye!